Hello from Shraddha from Love Pies. Moringai, kirai, podi. Podi made with lentils and moringa leaves. A fast-growing, drought-resistant tree native to the Indian subcontinent. Very, very nutritious, considered a superfood and easily available full year round. Make this podi, you can eat a little bit of it every day for health benefits. Enjoy it with idlis, uttapam, dosas, also with simple ghee and chawal, it tastes really, really good. So give it a try, to like, to subscribe and click on the bell icon for notifications. All the recipes are given in the description box below. Have a look. Until next time, bye-bye. Let's heat a pan to make our murungai kirai podi today. For that, I've taken some moringa leaves. I had plucked it from the tree and sun-dried it, adding that to the hot pan. And we'll quickly just roast it, not for long, just for a few seconds. We don't want to burn this. It's done. We're going to take it out in another bowl and let it cool. To the same pan again, we'll take some odad dal and again roast it until pink in color. Our odad dal is done too. You can see it's turned pink. We're going to take it out in another bowl for now. To the same pan, we'll add some peppercorns and lightly roast it. Our peppercorns are done. When they start popping like this, means we need to take them off the pan now. Heat the pan again, and to that we're going to add some chana dal and dry roast it till it's slightly pink in color and you get a fragrance. Do it on medium low. Make sure you don't overdo it, otherwise it's going to be a very burnt flavor. Here, it's done. It's turned slightly pink. We're going to take it out in another bowl for now. Next comes in some sesame seeds. Again, we roast it until they start popping, which they've already started. So these get done very quickly. We need to take this off the pan. Lastly, we're going to add a bit of oil to the pan. If you have sesame oil, please use that. I didn't have, so I'm using coconut oil. Very little. And to that, we're going to add some chilies to roast. This is pandi chili or pondi chili. And some Kashmiri chili and just roast it. Make sure you don't burn it. Chilies are done. I'm taking them out and letting them cool for now. Once your moringa leaves get cold, take it in a mixer grinder, coarsely grind it. Moringa leaves are done. I'm taking it out in another bowl for now. Once your chilies have cooled, make sure you break off the heads and put them in a mixer grinder. To the mixer grinder, we're going to add our odad dal, which is cool now. Chana dal, sesame seeds, peppercorns, and the red chilies to coarsely grind it. We need to add a bit of salt, salt to taste, a little bit of asafoetida or hing. It's ground to a coarse powder. Take your moringa leaf powder which you had made, the dals, etc., and mix it together. Just taste it so that your salt is just perfect. If you need to add more, please do that now. Moringa podi is ready. Enjoy it with your South Indian delicacies with a lot of ghee or clarified butter as you call it. And you will love it. Give it a try guys and give a boost to your health. Thank you.